In some ways, you might say Lagrange's theorem is a generalization of the fundamental theorem of cyclic groups to non-cyclic groups, as long as they're finite. Lagrange's theorem, which some people call the fundamental theorem of finite groups. It only applies to finite groups, not infinite groups. You could argue it's the most important theorem of finite group theory. It's not a complete generalization of the fundamental theorem of cyclic groups, only a partial generalization. What does the fundamental theorem of cyclic groups say? It says a lot. It says if G is a cyclic group, a finite cyclic group, and what does it say? It's got, then it's got one, exactly one subgroup, a unique subgroup for each number of order equal to each number that divides the order of the original group. So like if the original group has order 40, what are the divisors of 40? 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, 10, 20, and 40. 8 divisors of 40, that means there's exactly 8 subgroups of the original cyclic group of order 40, one for each of those orders. And also those subgroups themselves are also cyclic as well. Makes sense. And you can get into things like what are the generators and that kind of thing. Lagrange's theorem is a partial generalization of that. Let G be a finite group. And let H be a subgroup of G. The conclusion is then the order of H divides the order of G, which, if we use our textbook's notation, involves lots of vertical lines. The order of H divides the order of G, make the divides one bigger. In other textbooks, they use O for order. Like a little o of H divides little o of G. That's not a zero, that's an O, cursive. Says a little bit more than that. There's a second sentence related to something called the idea of a coset. But at the moment, since we haven't talked about cosets, this is good enough for us. Be careful to understand what this does not say. This does not say, for example, you got a finite group of order 40, that there's a subgroup of order 8, for example. Doesn't say that, even though 8 divides 40. It doesn't say that just because one number divides another, where the bigger number is the order of the finite group, that there's a subgroup of order equal to the smaller number. It says if you got a subgroup of the bigger finite group, then the order of that subgroup must divide the order of the groups. So the divisors of 40, for example, give you the possible orders of subgroups, not a guarantee that there is a subgroup of every such order. And if there is one subgroup of such an order, there's nothing about uniqueness either. There could be two subgroups or more that have the same order. In fact, we've seen examples like this. Think about like D4. R0, R90, R180, R270, H, V, D, D prime. These are the symmetries of a square. D4 has order 8. It does happen to have a subgroup for every divisor of 8. The trivial subgroup generated by the identity has order 1, and there's a subgroup order 2, a subgroup order 4, and a subgroup order 8. The subgroup order 8 is D4 itself. This is a subgroup of D4. However, the number of subgroups of order 2 and order 4 is more than just one of them. It's not unique. What are the subgroups of order 2? Order 2 subgroups. They're cyclic subgroups generated by any element of order 2, which includes the cyclic subgroup generated by R180, which is R0 and R180, cyclic subgroup generated by any of the reflections, H, V, D, and D prime. Those are all the order 2 subgroups because they're generated by all the elements of order 2. Any group of order 2 has to be cyclic. There are some also some order 4 subgroups, and in fact, more than one of them. We talked about this a couple weeks ago. There is a cyclic one, the one generated by R90, which is the same as the one generated by R270, which includes all the rotations. R0, R180, oops, I meant to write a 90 there. R90, R180, R270. But then there are also some non-cyclic subgroups of order 4 that are not isomorphic to this one. You can't write them with a generator. We talked about this. You have to include R0 along with 3 elements of order 2 that all commute. R180 has got to be in there. And then you got some choices for the other two. If you include H, you also have to include V, it turns out, we saw. But not D or D prime. If you do R0 and R180 and include D, you also have to include D prime. And we saw that there are no others. We did talk about this a couple weeks ago. So there's one subgroup of order 1, one subgroup of order 8, 5 subgroups of order 2, and 3 subgroups of order 4. But there are no subgroups of order 3, for example, or order 7, or order 5, or order 6. And if there were, that would be a contradiction of Lagrange's theorem. Because Lagrange's theorem says if you've got a subgroup of a finite group, the order has to divide the order of the entire group. So you can't have subgroup of order 3, 5, 6, or 7 in a group of order 8. It rules things out, rules possibilities out. That's pretty powerful.